こんにちは、根崎ゆきです。1月10日のセッションリーキャップ取っていきたいと思います。よろしくお願いいたします。それでは始めていきましょう。
breaks down into this wide open space here. We've had a break. We're now doing the hook. We're looking for the go. Down to 2998. Right in this area, right in here. Alright, so there's about 60 pips right there. Don't want to miss that at all. If for some reason it doesn't do that and breaks out, you can see you're going to come back to the support right here. If it breaks out here, you're going to go back up to the support. Alright, you would then have to redo the trend to the upside, and there would be your opportunity to the upside. Alright. So, pound dollar. Trying to do the same.
今のユーロドルですね、ちょっと一回戻って。
Go back up to the support.
もうちょっと戻りましょう。
Down to 2998.
1.2998まで下がるんじゃないかと。ブレイクしてフックして2998まで戻るんじゃないかと。
Right in this area, right in here. Alright, so there's about 60 pips right there. Don't want to miss that.
なのでこのトレードあと60ピップぐらいありますので見逃したくないですねということを言っていますね。
If for some reason it doesn't do that and breaks out, you can see you're going to come back to the support right here. If it breaks out here, you're going to go back up to the support. Alright, you would then have to redo the trend to the upside, and there would be your opportunity to the upside. Alright. So, pound dollar. Trying to
で、まあ上にブレイクしてきたら線を引き直しましょうということですね。ポンドドル見てみましょう。
Do the same thing, breaking down to the downside. We've got a strong bottom down here and they're having trouble breaking that. Alright, if you can see, I'm on a 240 chart. Alright, so that's where I go.
今240分チャートで強いサポートの上にありますねと。
Alright, unless I can see it early, easier on a 60. There's the wide open space right here. Alright, we're looking to trade it down to 5916.
5916 5916までトレードしたいですね。
If it doesn't do that, breaks up into here, that all these lines are going to stop it. It's going to hook and break, and you can see there's a bottom right here. There's a, this, what is support in the future? What is the support in the future? We talked about it earlier. It's resistance. Alright.
まあ今これ240分チャートで。もしブレイク下にしてこなかったらこのフックバック戻ってきますね。その時にサポートがここにありますね。でサポートが何になりますか？レジスタンスになりますねということを言ってますね。
That means that we would go back up to the resistance right here. Well, if that were to happen, we'd have to redo our lines to the upside. But you can see, if as a general thing, that's where we would try to go to the upside. Should it break out of this downtrend right here?
そしたらまた線を引き直さなくてはいけません。
It's really not a trend. It's just a channel right now.Can't, there is only
ドルカナダ
one trade period, and that's if we can get out of the box here. We got a big box we're working. Everybody should be able to see this big box. As long as we're in the box, we're trading inside this box, and it's all choppy jump.
ドルカナダは今この四角の中に動いていて、これを抜けてくるしかトレードする方法がありません。
But if we break the box to the downside, there's one trade right there.
もし下にブレイクしてきたら、ここに一つトレードあります。
If that happens, they don't call it the loony for nothing. Dollar Swissy.
ドルフラン.
We have no trade until we get up to above 9300, right up in this area.
9300上に超えてこないとトレードはありません.
We've got two trades stacked on top of each other, waiting to happen. Right. So if the currency it is already broken out here and it's now hooked, so if it takes a move up here, it has to get through this mess. There's only 20 pips here.So don't trade it in here. Wait for the break here, and now you've got 90 pips up to the top. So you wait till it breaks the 9300, break, hook, and belt.
まあ9300までは20ピップぐらいしかないので、それをブレイクしてフックしてから go エントリーしましょう。
Alright, there it is. Dollar yen.
ドル円.
We're looking forward to continue on to the upside, which it has done here.Now, we're now into the wide open space that we were looking for. You see this? We're back into the old trend.
ドル円は今ワイドオープンスペース、コンティニュー、買いが継続しているところですね。で、今ワイドオープンスペースがあるので、これ買っていきたいなという感じです。で、前あった前のトレンドに戻ってきましたと。
There's our space right there. We are interested. This will probably happen in the Asian session. This is going to be a nice little trade should it happen. Alright?You can tell the old trend is gone. This wedge that we're in is gone. So let's take that off so it doesn't confuse us. All right. We can now adjust this trend. Let me scrunch this up. All right. And we'll adjust this trend to be, all you gotta do is connect the bottom. And then let this one drive. I kind of like that because that's an anomaly. And that'll put us right here. Let's see if that works for us. Yeah, it works pretty well. Alright. And how do I do that? I found the bottom. There's a support. I use the resistance up here and trying to prove that heart line. Did the heart line get proven? Is that heart line proven?
まあ、トレンドラインを引き直さなくちゃいけなくなりましたと。じゃあまず下のトレンドライン1点目2点目を引いて、上はレジスタンス、まあ、サポートとレジスタンスを取った。で大事なのがこの真ん中のハートラインと呼ばれるところがプルーブンされているか、つまり証明されているかどうか、されてますねっていうことですね。
I will pip. Yeah. Yeah. See, so I can count on that trend. I don't know where the upper bar is, but I can count on it because I know where the bottom is here. I'm going to take these sieves off. I'm going to take the HSI off. I'm going to take the path projector off and this set of fibs right here.And now, I'm going to fib from here, swing low, to the swing high, to get my fib lines in here, alright? So let's put the fibs on from bottom, top, alright? Now, check and see if they know where the lines are, okay?
で、今度はフィブを引きましたと。どこまで戻ってくるのかなっていうフィブを引いて、まあ、当たってますよねっていうことをやってます。
Alright, looks like they do.Would you say they know where the lines are? Yeah. All right, so this is my first barrier to the top right here. See there? I can now put another set of fibs on from the bottom. I've had a 100 pip retracement. All right, that was an ABC retracement. We're now on a, potentially a new 5-pip, 5-wave move to the top. All right, now I got to get PSRs on here. All right, so that's going to be difficult because I'm up in a real high area.
で、今 HSI も下から引きましたと。で、今度はサポートレジスタンスを見に行きましょう。
So let me go to 240 here, see where I'm at. 240, yeah. Nothing here, let's go to the day chart. Anything here? Yeah, we've been here, you can see the moving average right there. Alright, so we're gonna go to the day chart. Ooh. I'm gonna flame into a bottom right there, on that move up. Then there's one right there, on that move up. And there's one right there, on that move up. Alright, so this is the top.I'll put a line on here so I know where that top is.
今取ったのがまずここのサポートですよね。そしてその次のサポート、この動きのサポート。で、その次この動きのサポート。で、最終的にはどこが高値になったかっていう、まあ、このトレンドを取りました。このトレンド。で、今のレートがここですよね。この黒い枠のところ。これより上のアップトレンド。この動きとこの動きとこの動きのトップを取りました。
Change the color so I don't think it's a...PSR.
で、色はちゃんとトップ、高値っていうところは色を変えておきます。
Now, we can now look at the currency and tell what our targets are. Remember, we don't do a trade unless we know where we're going. We never make a trade, right? So we can see right now, the best opportunity would be a pullback here and a bounce up to these two right here. Don't trade it in this area right here.Wait till you take the top out. There's not enough room in here. Top, hook, and a go.
はい。今一番いいオポチュニティ選択肢としては、これがフックバックしてくること。少し戻して跳ね返って、まず一つ目のターゲットを取る。で、そこでまあ決済して、この高値ですよね。高値まではトレードしない。で、高値をブレイクしてフックしてきたら、また次のターゲットまで取っていきましょう。という感じですね。
Moving your stop to 2705. See how easy that was? That wasn't hard?I know a strategy, know exactly what to do, know where the wide open spaces are, and know where to move my stop. Not hard, folks.
Alright, but how... 2702に来たらストップ上げましょうと。簡単ですよねと。
How come I do it so fast? I've done 25,000 of them. You've done 6. You got a long way to go. You got to go do lots and lots and lots and lots of lines.
まあ、簡単ですよねと。PSR、サポートレジスタンス、プレビアスサポートレジスタンスを引いて、HSI 引いて、フィボナッチ引いて、トレンドライン引いてっていうことをやっただけですよね。で、今すぐに終わりましたよね。なぜなら私は2万5000回、これをやってるからだよ。あなたはまだ6個しかやってないよ。だからもっともっとやっていきましょうね。そしたらすぐに引けるようになりますよと言っています。
I know exactly how to trade this. Alright? So that's what we're looking for. Aussie dollar.
Aussie dollar.
We have a breakout here, but we're not going anywhere. Alright? We don't have a trade till we get up in this area here above 105.70. up to 106.10 right there.
105.70.1.0570 抜けてから106.10.1.0610を狙ってくるね。
ユーロ円。
まあそこまでやることないよということですね。じゃあユーロ円いってみましょう。
Popping up, you know, we see the yens are breaking, but we're still inside a wedge. Are we a buyer yet when we're inside of a wedge?
まあ円絡みが上がってきましたねと。で買い手になってきますけど、まだだけど買いじゃないですよね。なぜならウェッジの中にあるからです。ウェッジの時は今買うんですかと聞いています。
No.
No ですよね。No ですよね。
Wait till it proves what it's doing. It can hit that line and scream right down. Or it can break, hook, and go. If it breaks, hooks, and goes, I can see I got a double top. But I'll have to redo my trend just like I just did over on the dollar yen.
はい。まあ、ブレイクして下に行くかもしれないし、ブレイク、フック、ゴーして上行くかもしれない。で、上行ったらこのダブルトップを目指してくる。そうしたら今度はまたドル円でやったように線のトレンドラインの引き直しをしなくちゃいけないと。
Once it makes that happen, it already happened on the dollar yen, so I can do it, but I can't do it here yet. Pound yen,
ポンド円。
Virtually the same thing, as you see, we're trying to break out here. If that happens, I gotta redo the trend, all the lines just like I just did. Alright?So, right now, this could just as easy come screaming back down to the bottom. If it breaks, hooks, and goes, you can see, if nothing else, you got the double top to shoot for. But you got to redo your lines once that happens.
ポンド円も同じくですよね。下に行きそうですけども、これブレイクしてきたら、ブレイクしてきてフックしたらダブルトップを取っていきましょうと。で、同じように、ドル円とかユーロ円と同じように線を引き直す必要がありますねと。
New Zealand?
キウイドル。
We got this breakout of the bullish wedge here. We got a bullish wedge. We have broken out of the wedge, so we're above it right here. But notice, they know exactly where that target is. Then there's another one right here. All right, so our only trades are right here and right here, if it will continue.
はい。キウイドルは、ブルの、ブルウェッジですよね。ブルの方、買いの方のウェッジをブレイクしてきました。だからといってまだ買うわけではなくて、まあターゲットがもうここって分かってますよね。でこれを超えてきたら1つ目のターゲット、2つ目のターゲットまで取りたい。そしてその上をもう1個取りたい。という感じです。
Will it continue? I don't know. But we'll be a buyer above 8420 with a break, hook, and...
8420、8420より上で買いです。
And a go, and a break, hook, and a go here. 8420. Two trades here. One and two. Alright. Over to the exotics. The yen, we're waiting for to the upside. Makes sense because we're seeing the pound yen, the dollar yen, and the euro yen all break to the upside. We've already figured that out over here in the Aussie yen because they never broke out of the uptrend. All they did was correct the uptrend. Now all we can see is we've got this big area right up in here with a double top right here. Alright. So if we get this first trade, it's a small trade right here. And we want to move our stop, stay in it for a break, hook, and a go up to
9381 まで、買っていきたいねと。で今、ダブルトップをめがけてまず一つ買って、抜けてきたらストップを上げてフックアンドゴーでもう一回買っていきたい。
Which was previous support, now it's resistance.
これはこの水色の線が前回のサポート、ここですよね。サポートで今レジスタンスになっているところを狙っていくと。
Euro pound, we're still in this trade. Hey.
ユーロポンド、まだ、買っていますよね。まだ、昨日買いのアラート出てそのままです。
Hey, things are going our way. Hooray, hooray, hooray. Nice job. We're working our way up to the top here. That's good.
で今、right. 狙ってるのはこのトップですよね。トップまで狙っています。
Now, you know, I'd be leery about all of you who have not taken this trade. We got in down here. We're all hanging on here.But I would be leery of you taking the trade at this point in time. Because there's quite a few barriers to the upside here. I'd kind of pass on it. And if you do take the trade, get a little hook here and back down, you'll want to be trading it up to 8228 roughly.
8228, 8228まで取っていきたいね。
Alright, so you'll be in it till Friday, so be
able to... で、金曜日まで多分持つことになりますけどねと。
Fair enough.Alright, we've got the euro breaking and hooking. Aren't you glad you didn't take the sell now? We've broken back up to the support. Gee, I wonder if anyone that is. I don't know. Doggone that Scott. He's so lucky. Alright, so here we are at the 240 chart. Could that be the bottom? Absolutely. Alright. If it's a head and shoulders, what will it do? It'll come back up and then go back down and then go back up. If it comes a head and shoulders, come up in here, it'll come back out and then it'll break out. And then you'll have a head and shoulders. Alright.So, do you want to take the buy here when you could get the scooper down and put the right shoulder in? Does anybody want to know that? No, we don't want that trade until it proves what it is. We'll be a buyer outside of here. But right now, we're currently a seller looking for this trade right here. So the break at 2405 down to 2051, if it will happen. As you can see, set of twins means they're going to play closed and reversed here. That doesn't mean they're reversing all the way up to here. They closed and reversed here, and what they did, they came back up to support and screened it back down for 200 pips. So they could do the same thing here, come back up, it'll be a lower high. All right, if they want to continue this trend to the downside, they may come up here and scream it right back down to the downside. So we'll look for that around 2,500 for the sell back down to here. This target's already out. This target's already out. That's the next target. These are now barriers to getting to this line right here.
ユーロ王子、まあ、このようになってますよねと。で、ヘッド&ショルダーも見えますし、まあ、一回フックワークしてきて下がってくるんではないでしょうかと言っています。ユーロカナダ。
Ooh, boy, aren't you glad you didn't make that trade? Man, oh man. All right, let's take this up to 240. And we'll look at it. Again, we could have a bottom in place. Do we know that? We don't have a clue. All right. So, if this comes up, makes a turn, we're looking for that trade right down there. So we're waiting for it to crash into the trend wall, turn to the downside, and go to 2805. If it breaks, hooks out of here, We could go all the way up to this previous support. We'll have to redo our lines then if that happens because it's a reversal.
はい、ユーロカナダ、ユーロカナダですよね。これは、トレンドラインブレイクしてきてますから、まあこのまま下に行くかもしれないし、フック&ゴーで上に行く。そして上に行ったらその時はこのサポートまで、狙ってくることになりますねということを言っています。
Have to do our lines to the top.
でまあ、上まで行ってサポートまで行ったら、また線を引き直さなくてはいけません。
But that's a possibility on the breakout right there. Canadian.
カナダ円行きましょう。カナダ円はトレードのアラート来てましたよね。またブログの方で見てみてください。
We're underway here. We're invalidating this, trying to invalidate the head and shoulders potential here right now.We're trying to validate that. If we break this right shoulder here, up into this area, there's a trade right here. It doesn't look like much, but it is about 40 pips. So be aware, that's a day chart top right there.
はい。今このヘッド&ショルダーのパターンの右肩ですよね。これをブレイクしてきたら、このあと40ピップトップ、デイチャートのトップのピンクの線までトレードできますねと。
So, New Zealand yen.
9円。
Staying here. On top of this, we don't have any room left now. We got a little wedge working, which is a buy sign to there. There's only 30 pips here, folks. The better trade is if it will build a bull flag down here, that's the trade you want. No matter what you look at, that's the top right there at 74.10. Moving your stop at 74 if you take the pullback and the bounce. Pound New Zealand, for those of you...
ポンド、ニュージーランド。
Can trade it. All right. We bottomed out this morning here, and you notice that they're not bouncing. They're keeping their head down. All right. Which means that means that this target's already been taken out. That was a day chart bottom. So the next trade would go down below that if they want to keep that. You go into the 270 fib, basically moving yourself at 1.9000 and hanging into
8978. 8978. 8978. 8978を目指してますが、まず9000でストップを下げましょうと。このデイチャートのボトムをもう取ってきましたよねと。この下を今狙ってきていますと。
はい。Nice opportunity to downside there. Alright. This is a great trade for those who made it. Jamal made it, I know. Maybe Frankie, I can't remember what Frankie did, but Jamal made that trade right there. Nice job, Jamal. And, okay, folks. That's what I see. There's the announcements. Be very careful. Remember, there's lots of stuff happening tomorrow. Got, 7:30 in the morning, you definitely need to be flat in the market. That's all I can tell you on any dollar-based currency anyway. All right, so we have Aussie this afternoon, or actually this evening. Building approvals might move the market there. And if you want to vote, this is a good time to vote for us. Go to the link that Pip's posted in there for you and help keep us in the number one position. All right, everybody. Thank you for everything you do. Thanks for being here.We'll see all of you tomorrow morning. You bet.
はい、いよいよ終わりました。まあ、昨日ですよね、昨日も HSI のトレードがあって、HSI と点々を使った僕たちチャートマスターのトレードがあって、ユーロオージー、あとユーロオージーとポンドドルですね。で、ちょうど、S2 から S3 までのトレードがあって、ユーロオージーは S の3まで取れました。約50ピップ。 で、ポンドドルの方は、ちょうどリミットのぴったりぐらい取れてましたね。20ピップ、25ピップとかそれぐらい取れました。で、現在なんですけども、現在は昨日のユーロ王子、ポンドドルに続いて、ユーロポンド、ユーロドル、そして、あと何でしたっけ、あとドルカナダか。この辺ですよね。あとユーロカナダもそうですね。もう一回言います。ユーロドル、ユーロカナダ。あとユーロポンド。そしてドルカナダ。この4つの通貨ペアでサインが出そうなので、PA チャートをお使いの方はぜひ見てみてください。そんな感じです。どうもありがとうございました。失礼します。